Hi guys, this is Kara, aka KManson65, and I have done videos before showing my various Sabbat setups for my altars, but I don't think I've ever done one for my working altar, so I just thought I'd do a quick video on this very powerful, special lunar eclipse full moon. My cat is bumping my elbow. That's why the camera keeps moving here. Here's my kitty, Kelty. He's my beautiful... Hi there, baby! He's my beautiful medium. Anyway, so I thought I'd do a real quick video showing you guys what my working altar looks like in case anybody's looking for ideas like I was when I first started. So, without further ado, here we go. And there's my cat at my elbow again. Real quick, this is my wooden plate that I keep all of my polished, or all my small stones on. And I usually keep it in my witchy cabinet, which is over here. But lately I've been feeling kind of bad keeping them all cooped up all the time. Oh, there's my kitty again. Not that they have feelings or anything, but they're my babies to me. But, so I'm trying to figure out where I can keep them out. Come on, Kelty. Once or twice is cute. After that, it's not cute anymore. Anyway, that's what those are there for. These are my peacock feathers. I love peacocks. Anyway, onto my altar. This is just a fun little pretty jar that I put Christmas lights in that I just really like the way it looks. And so I like the thought of keeping a little bit of the Christmas spirit around every day. So that's why that's on my altar. Let's go in here. This is my very first crystal. Point to that right there. His name is Fred. I don't know why. He just said he wants to be called Fred. Right now, or for the most part of my working altar, I keep my god representation is Ganesh, so that he may remove any obstacles that may be in my path and bring abundance in all aspects of my life. Where were you next? That's my working candle. This is my beautiful big piece of citrine to keep all of the energy on my altar always clean and cleansed at all times. That is, use my finger. This is my chime that I use for meditation and for space clearing. Isn't that gorgeous? I just love that sound. This is my wand that I made myself out of a piece of fallen branch from my yard. I carved the symbols in it with my wood carver and then affix some of my favorite crystals. This is a piece of horn from a deer that's naturally fallen, and I use this, it's kind of hard to, the light's really bright in here right now, but I use this to, the word is escaping me, to inscribe on my candles when I do candle spells. My holy, well, I call this a holy stone or a fairy stone. I love labradorite. It's my favorite stone of any stone, and so I always have lots and lots of pieces of it everywhere. It's good for intuition. This is a new smoky quartz that I got that I need to cleanse. This is my god candle, god representation candle. It's getting pretty small right now. I need to put a new one in. Back here are some stones that represent God energy to me, and in the summer aspect, this is my, what I call Smokey Junior, my Smokey Quartz crystal. This is just a really tiny piece of rutilated quartz. This is a little bead thing that I got on eBay from a really talented lady that represents Earth to me. Amazonite, malachite, and my green man little thing that I made. I'm so descriptive today, aren't I? Sorry. Here is my little abundance, may abundance be yours card that I always keep on my altar to attract abundance into my life. A lapis pendant, again for abundance, a dendritic agate, again for abundance, my amethyst mala beads that I use to meditate quite often, my representation of the elements and my pentagram. I have a blue jay feather for air. I have some stones that I got out of a stream in Muir Woods, California for earth. I have a fluorite candle for fire, and I have the seashell I got from the ocean in San Francisco, and an ammonite fossilized seashell. Up here is my two candle holders that I use for my working altar to put candles depending on what the intentions I'm trying to set, what I'm trying to draw in, or spells I'm trying to do. This is my piece of amethyst spirit quartz. I love amethyst too. That's my second favorite stone. Here is a piece of pyro, I don't remember. I'll put it in the description field. It's like, looks kind of like peacock ore, and it's supposed to be very good for helping you find lost things. This is a labradorite sphere, another one of those little sculpy beads. This is for the moon representation. This is my Kuan Yin that a dear friend of mine got for me. This is my goddess offering statue that I made myself. This is my current representation of the goddess in her maiden form. I need to change that out for summer solstice. This is what I'm currently using for a cauldron. It is handmade pottery made by my stepdaughter, so it's real special to me. This is my rose quartz sphere that I just got at the Gem and Mineral Show, which I dearly love. Another crystal that has a feminine form to it, so I'm trying to draw femininity and feminine spirituality. My goddess candle, which is nearly gone. This is my little fluorite pyramid or statue thingy-dooey, trying to bring, again, more sexuality and sensuality into my life. This is my amethyst, double-terminated amethyst that I just got too. Here is my new skull, of which I don't know what it is made out of. If I can get it into a different light. If anybody has any ideas, I know my video camera on my camera isn't very good. But if you have any ideas what that is, I'd be more than happy to entertain them. This is my Oregon opal. Azurite, another labradorite. I have a piece of shugalite here, moldavite, and a tiny little Herkimer diamond to amp up all the energies of the rest of the stones. My new quartz wand. I apologize that I can't really focus in very well. And my new amethyst wand. So that is pretty much what I do, what I have on my altar most of the time. I can change the stones out here and there depending on what I want to draw into and attract into my life. Up here is my, God, I just cannot think today. My broom, that is always there. I really never take it down. I don't use that ritually. It's there symbolically. So I hope this helps anybody who may have, who may be looking for any ideas on what to use in their working altar. Blessed be, and may everybody have a fabulous full moon Sabbat and lunar eclipse. Love and laughter, Kara.